Harvey has enjoyed a hugely successful career, first as a comedian and actor, and later as a wildlife presenter.
Yes, but when he was young, he needed a sanctuary of his own and found it in a surprising place.
We're in Birmingham, and this is King Edward School. This is where I came between 1954 and 1960, so it's as if but yesterday. After many people at school now, and they haven't won for years, we started the demise.
Well, maybe.
This was the scene of my first performances, and this was about, I don't know, 56 or 57, something like that. And it was a review with comedy and songs. Oh, look, I've got a credit here. Harmonica played by W.E. Oddy. And a couple of years later, so just before I went, July 20th and 21st, 1959, we have Let's Face It. But this time it was written by myself. I know we got terribly good reviews. On two successive nights, the large audiences in Big School applauded a performance of which the standard was very high. Thing that's striking me is how many of the things I've gone on to do through the whole of my life actually began at this school. People always talk about me as part of the Cambridge mob and the Footlights, but it was here that I actually got into those things.
Omid, on the subject of skill, right, yes. is this fact or is this pure standard?
Be careful what
that you've sat 49 papers of A-levels trying to get those in.
Rachel, yes, that's true.
Is that true?
It's awful, I know.
40.
I did 4 A-levels 13 times.
Right.
You're not feeling that now, are you?
Where do you stand with those now? Have you got your qualifications?
Yeah.
No, I never got them. What happened was I was tremendously deluded. I'd do an exam and I wait for the exam result. I think it was A. I messed up one bit of the paper. It might be a B, it could be an A. I hope it'll be an F. I'll be completely flawed.
Oh, no.
And then I did them 3 years in a row. And it was a total of 49 papers.
Right.
And I ended up... I didn't really get any. I think I got a C and 3 E's.
I mean, you'd never tell from all your filmography and all the movies you've been in and everything.
Can I keep it quiet? I don't say it on the telly, do I?
Well, you tried for 16 drama skills as well.
You heard that as well? What is this? I mean, this is ridiculous. This is total BS. I come here exposing my life.
Yeah, 16. I did 8 drama schools twice. Did you find this stuff? Eight times
sorry,
each.
Time.
And you know, one of them, the Welsh School of Drama, they were very kind because the second time I said, look, what am I doing wrong? And they said, we think you're very arrogant, and we think you might have the fat gene. And which means we think you're thin now and you've got hair, but we're still all going through.
Yeah.
No, it's true. And they actually said to me, we think that you have enough confidence to try something out with yourself and don't go through drama, because drama school, we like to mold people.
Yeah.
Just go out and do it.
Yeah.
There you go.
Okay.
Well.
Okay, but we won't embarrass you anymore. Now we'll move on.
Sorry.
Despite hundreds of alleged sightings so far, there's no conclusive evidence that big cats are roaming the British countryside.
However, on the Ardnamurchan Peninsula in Loch Abbott, a very rare species of cat does live in the wild, but as Mike Dilger discovered, it's nearly as elusive. Judging from that map, I'm not surprised.
This area in Scotland is a stronghold for a rare and shy cat. Cats have to be one of the most elusive mammals of Britain. With only about 400 remaining in the wild, they have to be one of the rarest as well. It's certainly an animal that I have never seen before. Add to that, they do everything they can to avoid being detected. In fact, wild cats have rarely been filmed. This footage was taken in 2008, but their elusiveness hasn't deterred scientists from doing everything they can to protect the last remaining wildcats. Up here on the Ardnamurchan Peninsula in West Scotland, there's a very special wildcat project taking place, and I'm keen to get involved. Adrian Davis from the Scottish Wildcat Association is dedicated to preserving our only native feline. And having spent his life trying to track them down, he's all too aware of how rare they are.
I mean, I've only, I think, seen 5 in the wild. And I've seen a few in zoos, but 5 in the wild over 40-odd years is not many.
Especially in this landscape, it's almost like a needle in a haystack. But how different are they to the common garden tabby cat that people would know as a domestic pet?
Well, they're quite some ways, they have that sort of stripy marking that a tabby has, but they have a very distinctive tail, which is very stripy, and it has a dark black blunt tip, as well as this bushy tail. So that's what really gives it its character.
But also fierce.
Oh, incredibly fierce, and hence the name the Scottish Tiger.
Wildcats are usually larger than the average tabby and play an important role in controlling populations of rabbits and rodents. But being so rare, very little is known about them. So Adrian is trying to catch them to find out more.
Hopefully it'll tell us a lot more about wildcats in this area and also build up some information about how many we have. And then extrapolating, hopefully it'll help us to estimate the population in Scotland.
Adrian is concerned there may be even fewer than 400 wildcats left, and it's because of a threat from feral cats. Once pets, many feral populations have lived in the wild for several generations, and they're causing problems.
The wildcats can potentially breed with feral cats as well, and that's unfortunate because it dilutes the pure wildcat population. So it can become basically a different type of cat, and they can potentially pass disease into the wild population. And if we don't do something now, then we may actually lose the wild cat.
So, to try and stop them interbreeding, Adrian is trying to lure in the feral cats with bait and catch them. But having lived wild for so long, these cats are canny.
It's very noticeable, they're going all around the cage. We're not actually in the Adrian, but you have caught quite a few here.
We've already caught probably 15, 16 cats here.
What are you doing with the cats once you've trapped them?
Once we've trapped the cats, we take them to the vets, and they're actually spayed and neutered and then re-released.
So they can't hybridise with genuine Scottish wild cats?
And they have a small clip taken on their ear, so we can instantly recognise them if they're recaptured.
Well, it's interesting to see cats that are almost, but not quite, wild, if you know what I mean. It makes me want to see a wild cat even more.
Although the closest I managed to get to a wild cat were these troublesome ferals. With Adrian's help, the wild cat population will hopefully increase, and my chances of seeing one next time will be even better.
Hawaii.
Thanks, Mike, for that. Well, on Friday night on the show, we asked you to send in your jokes, and you sent in hundreds. We're going to read some now. We didn't have time on Friday.
No.
So, Omid, will you kick us off?
Yes, this one's from Jackie Higgins. When I was a kid, people used to cover me with cream and put cherries on my head. It was hard growing up in the ghetto.
Yes! Love it!
I think
very good.
I sold it with that.
Very good. Okay.
Alex is going to laugh. He's been laughing at this.
Alex, you've got
try and get through without laughing.
Yeah.
I used to have an origami business, but it folded.
very apt.
Brilliant.
Very apt indeed.
No, I'm David.
Do you want to go watch that in mine? Okay, just made my hamster a strong coffee. Well, I don't want him falling asleep at the wheel.
That's
from Pablo. Cheers, Pablo.
And this is from Sarah Kennedy. It says, if you've seen one shopping centre, you've seen them all.
Seen them all. Seen them all.
Thanks for all your jokes. You can see Omid in the Tour of Duty until the 25th of February.
Okay, tomorrow we turn the lights down low. We're going to put on some sweet, sweet music and get romantic.
Yes, it's Valentine's Day and our guest is Steve Jones. We'll see you then.
Brilliant. Best gag of the night, that one.